Okay, if we start with our nasal cavity here, our entranceway is always a vestibule. We come on in, and we've got this here is going to be our dorsal nasal concha, or I prefer turbinates, that's just my preference. And this is the ventral nasal turbinates. And then back here coming off the ethmoid bone is the ethmoidal turbinates. That's where the olfactory epithelium is at. These spaces, so the space dorsal to the dorsal nasal turbinate is the dorsal nasal meatus. And we have a middle nasal meatus. And then the ventral is going to be down in here. And basically we also have a septum here. You can see a little bit of the nasal septum here is cartilaginous. And the space between the septum and the turbinates right here is known as the common nasal meatus. And so the junction of the common and the ventral is generally where you pass a nasogastric tube. And you can see here, right there, from the nasal cavity into the nasopharynx, that is called the quinae. Okay, so we're up in the nasopharynx. What is this hole right here? That's going into the auditory tube. So this is the opening into the auditory tube. This goes into the middle ear, which is what allows you to equalize pressure in your ears, causing them to pop. So like when you chew gum or when babies suckle, that kind of opens that up to allow that pressure to equalize when you're flying. Okay, so we have soft palate here, nasopharynx all the way back to this arch here. What is this arch here that we cut? Palatopharyngeal arch.
Okay,
so that goes from your nasal pharynx into your laryngeal pharynx. Okay, and as we said, these kind of torn up a little bit here, but our palatoglossal arch tells us the rostral aspect of our oral pharynx.
Mm-hmm.
Oral pharynx comes back to about here, and within that we see, what do we have here? Palatine tonsil, and it's got this fold of tissue which is the called the semilunar fold.
Yeah,
looks like a moon or something. Okay, so this is our laryngeal pharynx up here, and we already traced that to the pharyngeal esophageal lumen. Okay, let's see, is there anything else we wanted to cover here?
So the laryngeal pharynx is just...
yeah, it's this portion around the larynx right here up to the lumen.
Okay. Let's see. And then for the soft palate versus hard palate.
You see the bone here.
Mm-hmm.
That's the hard palate. And then the soft palate begins here and ends here.
Okay.
And if we had a vomeronasal organ, it would be sitting right up here. Generally, the epiglottis is going to be sitting dorsal to the soft palate right there. In the dog, they can do this, so they can breathe through their mouth like this.
Mm-hmm.
But we're going to find in the horse, it is always like this.
Okay. Now, why is that important? Or does that just block off things from...
well, that's our airway.
Okay.
We got to cross over in here. But when we swallow, we're then going to need to push that epiglottis back like this so we can push our bolus of food up.
Okay. And then when the epiglottis pushes back, now the trachea is closed off.
Yeah.
Okay. Great.
So we're going to have that in conjunction with our cricoarytenoideus, mm-hmm, lateralis and stuff closing off
okay
the glottis.
Perfect.